Hi everyone and welcome back. Welcome to my YouTube channel. And in this playlist we are covering Node.js different microservice patterns. And on the same line, now our next video is on CQRS pattern. So CQRS command query responsibility segregation, this is one of the most popular pattern when you have to isolate read and write operations. And this is being widely used nowadays in all different kind of application architecture. So on the similar part, Node.js provides a CQRS implementation. I mean, there is a Nest.js framework which provides the CQRS implementation. We can just look into this and we'll try to explore more about it. So let's have a look at Nest.js CQRS. So Nest.js provides this implementation. What it does is, here we are able to have the same kind of a structure in a single application. You can also create a multiple microservices, a splitting read and write operations. So what do we see here is a Nest.js CQRS module, which provide the same kind of a structure where you can create a query module, query handler, command handler, event bus, and all these things. Okay, so here if you see, the installation is simple, and this is how we will just create a command, like kill dragon command it is creating, and it is just pushing that command to the command bus. This dot command bus dot execute, and this is our kill dragon command. Now what kill dragon command is doing is, it is just getting the data from the command object, and then it is executing this. I mean, you can be persisting this to the repository or doing the final manipulation and saving it. So once this command is getting executed, right, what you can do is, you can also emit an event. So it is also event driven design kind of stuff, where once the command is executed, you can actually raise an event for particular command. So if we look into this, so what we are doing is, these are the things. You just execute a command through the command handler. So for that, Nest.js command handler, Nest.js query handler, it will do something on the repository. Repository is nothing but a representation of database entities. So through the domain model, you will raise an event. Okay, whatever the action you are performing, and you will just push it to the event bus. So here your operation has been done. You have executed the write operation, and then you have raised an event, and that event is also stored in the event store. So it's the same kind of a CQRS implementation with the event sourcing, when whatever the event you are raising, I mean whatever the operations you are doing, you are persisting the event associated with that action in the event store. It can be as simple as your simple MongoDB database. So here we can take a look onto this. Like, you can also create a sagas, and this is the query. And finally, you have to encapsulate everything, the command handler, query handlers, in a single repository. Okay, if we see our simple code, so we'll start from controllers. Like, this is the main module. Okay, event store dot for root and user module. So we have user module. Inside the user module, if we see what all controllers we have user controller, because Nest.js application controller is the primary thing after module, controller and services. From this controller, you can see we are creating few things. Like, this is the API, which is HTTP GET. Then these are the different operations: update user, put, delete, get, post. Okay, from these API endpoints, we are actually calling service, like create user, update user, delete user, find user. So our this APIs, REST APIs, are exposed to the client. So client will do the REST APIs, like get, put, post, delete. Here we are doing post. So this service, let's go to the service, create user. So create user is some kind of an operation you will do, right? You will actually create a new row in the database through the repository, like that table repository. So here we are using command bus. So there are three different commands we have: create user, update user, and delete user. Once the request came, we are actually creating the command, create user command. We are just creating the object of it. and we are sending this command to the event bus. Event bus dot execute, and this is my command. Command bus dot execute, and I'm sending these three different commands. These are nothing but simple classes which are extending I command, and this is the user DTO. Coming to our controller and service. So from service we are actually onboarding everything to the command bus. So here also you can see repository, and we are sending it to the command bus so that command handler can execute it. So there is a query handler, similarly there is a command handler. So command bus dot execute. Okay, now the rest of the part will be handled by the command handler. So here we will have our, these are just a create user simple handlers. So all these different commands, so this is the commands and their handler and implementation. Let me just minimize all these things. So here it will handle the create user command, delete user command, update user, and welcome user handler. So from the event bus we will be able to get, because here we are using command handler annotations create user command, so we are executing this execute method. We are inside async create user handler, and here you will get a user DTO, whatever we are getting in the payload, and this dot publisher dot merge object context, and this is being published to the repository dot create user. Okay, here we are actually publishing it to the event publisher merge context. So now some command has been raised, right, and you will be raising an event for that particular command, and you are handling it. So here repository dot create user, this will do nothing but save user in the database, and you also have raised an event for this. So I'm talking about this picture where you are at the repository, you are also creating the user in the using the repository and also raising an event. So merge object context repository dot create user, and you are also publishing this event. Okay, similarly the delete user, update user commands. So what we are doing in CQRS is, once the handler is handling it, it is just publishing that event after the repository is creating, updating, and deleting the users. Okay, so another important point is sagas. So sagas are doing nothing but some kind of manipulations. Here we are using Rx. So if you want to manipulate the data, so here we are using Rx, and in the Rx, once the observable is created in the pipe, you can actually do delay, map, tap, filter, merge map, switch map, all these kind of operations you can do with the data. This is independent service. Okay, so this is the flow of the command through the command handler to the event bus, and these repositories, user repositories, doing nothing but interacting with the database models and inserting, updating, and deleting. And this is our user entity, and once the command is executed, we are actually raising these events, user created event and all. Okay, moving to our queries. Okay, so this is our commands now. So we have query handlers. So this should be a get operation. User ID put, delete, get. So here we are doing find operation. Okay, and command bus dot execute delete user command. So here we can actually write our queries in the find user. So similar to the command handler, we can also write a query, and it will be handled by the query handler, and query handler will read the data and give it to us. So here we are isolating the read operations and write operations, segregate, we are doing segregation of it. Okay, and here we have implemented the event store. So whenever any particular event is getting raised, we are actually using event store module for that, and event store provider, here we are just using this event source config, like what is the protocol where we are storing all these set of events, and whatever the events is getting raised, we are just storing those events in our system. Okay, this is pretty much about CQRS. I mean, I haven't implemented CQRS natively in any project. We are using a different framework for this, but NestJS CQRS is one of the good choice. If you want to use it, then you can explore NestJS CQRS for your own implementation.